In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a tie-dye pattern in your designs so that you can make a t-shirt that looks like this. We're going to get the tie-dye pattern off the internet from Canva, and I'm going to show you how to put it all together in Affinity Designer. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I want to talk about tie-dye patterns. Now, when you think tie-dye patterns, you think of the whole shirt being tie-dyed, something like these right here. This is really popular, or has been really popular, in the 70s, and that 70s retro designs are coming back now. You're seeing it in patterns on t-shirts. I have a few videos about some of those. I have one right here with the wavy designs. Those are kind of 70s patterns, right? So this one is also kind of taking that 70s design element, the tie-dye, and putting it in your designs. And it's become really popular. If you look on Merch by Amazon, here are some ideas from Merch by Amazon, and as well as Redbubble. If you look up tie-dye, you can see tie-dye is very popular right now because of that 70s retro designs that are coming back. I'm gonna show you where you can get those tie-dye patterns from the internet. There's lots of different places. In this video, we're gonna look at Canva, but I'm gonna show you some other places that you can find tie-dye designs. And then I'm gonna show you how to put that design into your text or whatever object that you have in Affinity Designer. So we're gonna go step by step. It's really easy to do. You're gonna be surprised how easy it is to do once you find the tie-dye pattern. Basically, that's the hardest part, to find a good tie-dye pattern that works. So let's get into the internet right now and I'll show you where to find tie-dye patterns. All right, so here we are on the internet. I pulled up a couple of different places. So first, Creative Market. You may be familiar with that. You can go to creativemarket.com. Lots of different things you can find here, including fonts and graphics. So I just typed in tie-dye like this, and you can see lots of different ideas for tie-dye, different colors and things like that. They actually have mock-ups and different pastel tie-dyes and so on. They got pages and pages of them. So if you want to go here, if you're more comfortable here with Creative Market, they do cost. They're not free, but you can use these for commercial purposes, right? If you buy those rights. The next one is Creative Fabrica. They also have some cool stuff, and they have stuff where it's already done. So they got tie-dye in a bear, tie-dye in text, and different shapes. You can see here Mom Life with tie-dye already there. I'm going to teach you kind of how to do this in Affinity Designer by putting the tie-dye in the text. But if you don't want to do that yourself, you can see for $2 or whatever the cost is on some of these, they have it already done. So in flowers and things like that, right? And in Vectezi, if you go to Vectezi as well, I'll put all these links in the description. But there's some fun ones here with the colors. And these are photos, but there's also vector tie-dyes, right? And they say free, but if you click on here, and you'll have to do attribution, which is kind of weird for t-shirts. So I wouldn't do the free. Just go pay for it if you really like it, right? Because that's kind of hard to put attribution in your t-shirt designs. So lots of cool colors. I really like the selection here because this is kind of what we're looking for. Is these kind of tie-dyes, right? Now, I'm gonna use Canva for this tutorial. So I'm gonna go here in Elements. I'm already in Canva. I got my artboard here. You can see I've looked for some already. I'll show you how to do it. Tie-dye. And I'm on the Pro version. So you can see there's a ton of them for Pro. So if you're on Pro, just go to Graphics, Photo, not Graphics. Well, there's some graphics, but mainly Photo is what we want. You can see right here. Either one would work. The thing about photos is there's a lot more designs for the photos. And there are some free ones, but you're really limited. So I'll show you what the free ones are by clicking free here, apply filters, and you basically got these two. The other ones are kind of, I mean, I guess that's not really tie-dye. So we're gonna pick, just for those that only have the free version, I'm gonna show you how you can do it with the free version. So you got this one right here. Again, not the best tie-dye. It's not even filling the space, but you get the idea. I'm gonna put it top, so we have the whole thing right here. And this is my 4500 by 5400 artboard right here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit share, and I'm gonna go download. And you can't do transparent background for free. So I'm just gonna do what a free person would do, is PNG. I think you can still do PDF standard. So let's try that. PDF standard for free download. And it's gonna download to my desktop. I'm gonna pull that into Affinity Designer and I'll show you how to put this inside of some text. So here we are in Affinity Designer. I got my artboard, the 4500 by 5400. And then I brought in that picture, right? So you can see right there, the tie-dye. Now we just need some text. So I'm just gonna type in, I'm going to the artist text tool right here and type here, and I'm gonna do love, and I'll make this bigger. I'm just using this font right here, Nexa Rust Sans. You want a thick font, and if you can find a retro font, even better. This one's not very retro. We do have some retro ones in here, but find your favorite retro font, mainly kind of like wavy or kind of big and round and things like this. This one's not very round, but you'll get the idea on how to do it. I'm just gonna do this because it's easy. I'm gonna do love, peace, and joy. So peace, very easy. I'm copying, holding down option and copying these. So just typing in joy and you can come in here and tighten it up. So if you do option, hold down option and then left arrow, you can see I'm moving the E closer, moving the V closer, moving the O closer. You kind of want to tighten it up, especially when you have those retro text, kind of push it together as close as you can. And that's mainly so that you can see this pattern behind it a lot easier, right? So let me, because it makes it look more like one piece. So we saw that bear that had the tie-dye in the back of it, or any kind of silhouette. Silhouettes work really well because it's one big piece, so you can see the tie-dye a little better. So I'm just gonna come in here and tighten these up, and then move these kind of out so that they're one, and you don't have to do this, but I like making it so it's that rectangle, the tall rectangle, right? So we'll just bring this out right there. Very easy. So we got this whole thing now. We want to fill the space, kind of that tall rectangle space. You can see it's doing pretty well there. And kind of butt these up against, almost right up against each other. So. And that's gonna help with the design being in there. All right, so next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna convert these to curves. So we'll just hit convert curves right here and then ungroup them. And click this, convert curves and ungroup them. Convert to curves, ungroup, and last one here, convert to curves and ungroup. Now you should have all of these together as separate objects. And you're gonna put them all together right here. You can see this in the layers. I'm gonna show you. We're gonna add these all together, and now they're just one thing right here, you see it? So this will be the text. I'm gonna type in text. And now I'm gonna bring in this image over the text like this, and make sure that it covers all of the text. So we want that like that. And the last thing to do, and it's real simple, is grab it right here in the layers palette, bring it down and inside the text. So you see what I did there? And you'll see that it does it right here on preview, and let go. And there you go, it's right in there. Now, if you want a dark background, you can change this white to black just to kind of see what it would look like on a black t-shirt. And if you're not happy with this, where it's at, you can click on this right here and just move it around. So now it's moving around the text. So you can see maybe you want it a little lower, maybe you want the yellow to stand out over there, maybe you want to burst over the O, and you can make it bigger too. So if you want it just a lot bigger and take up the space, you can as well. Or smaller, if you want it just right up to the edge is what we did. So we're gonna do right up to the edge here. And you can see it's cutting off, it's not filling that. So make sure that it fills every letter right there. Now you could also put a white background around it just so it stands out a little more. And you just click on the text and click here and do a white background or any color you want. And then make the text, make sure the stroke right here is a little bigger. So you can see right here, I'm just making the text bigger. Now you may wanna put this on the outside. So right here, align stroke to outside, and you can see, boom, it does it. Very, very simple to do. Now, you could do this on an object as well. So if you wanna make your own peace sign, for example, let me show you how to do that. Let's move this artboard over here. I'm gonna do another artboard. I'm just gonna copy, option, click, drag. Let's get rid of these texts here and let's just do a circle. So hold down shift to make a perfect circle. You can take this width up big like that, make it in the center right there. So that's gonna start our peace sign, right? And just take our tool here, our pen tool, hold down shift to make it straight. And then a peace sign has straight here, these two lines. So we'll just take this pen tool again, kind of come right up to the middle here. And just so that we get that angle the same on the other side, you can hold down option and drag it here and then flip it right there. Okay. Now to make this an object, let's select all of these. Now these are paths, so we want to convert these paths. So go to layer and expand the stroke. Now it's one big thing, and make sure to hit this add again. So I had to take this out of here, the tie-dye pattern. So now that you have the tie-dye pattern here, we're gonna put it over the peace sign that you just made, and then we're gonna drag it into it like that. Now this peace sign has the tie-dye in it, and you can make it whatever you want. You could also put this, let's say this is a white background instead. You could do an opposite and put a black border on it. So like that. So that can be a cool sticker or whatever you want. You can do it with any object. We saw it on the bears. We saw it on different silhouettes, hand signs, peace signs, hang loose signs, whatever it is. You can do that on here. And you can change this too. So if you wanna come in here and play around with some of these, look at some of these things that it does. If you wanna do like a lighter one, this is hard light, this is vivid light. If you wanna scroll down to negation, or some of these other ones work kinda cool. This one is average, so it's kinda lighter. So you can play around with some of these filters as well. So styles, right? So play around with that. That's how you do it. Try it out with different fonts, with different objects, create your own objects and things like that. And I think it would do really well for print on demand, for t-shirts, as well as stickers on Redbubble and TeePublic and any place that sells stickers. So have fun with these. Create your own things. Don't copy anybody, but try different colors, try different tie-dye patterns that you find on the internet with different colors and things. So very versatile, very fun to do. Make some that are your own and hopefully get lots of sales. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button so that you can see all my videos and learn how to design t-shirts and other products for print on demand. The question of the day for this video is, have you done a tie-dye pattern before, or any pattern in text? Let me know that in the comments. If you like learning how to do different patterns, let me know what kind of patterns you would like to see. Thanks again for watching this video. And if you want to see more tutorials, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.